Well, good evening, everybody. Welcome to the final set of a very successful and wonderful Whitley Bay classic jazz party. Have you had a great weekend?
Yeah.
Well, wonderful. Well, this is the Paul Whiteman Orchestra, and my name is Josh Duffee, and I'll be your slim version of Paul Whiteman this evening, minus the mustache. And but it really is an honor for me to be standing on this stair-stepper from the gym down below to get myself up here. During the show, I'll do some steps, no. But it is a very big honor to have been asked to lead this orchestra. Since this was Keith Nichols' idea. The music, everything was his idea, and he wanted to do the show. And unfortunately, you know, he passed away. So Klaus and Michael had asked me to do this. I'm not a conductor, so you're gonna see some butchering on my part, but the music is gonna be beautiful, and every note that these musicians play is gonna be for Keith and for Franz, because I know the last time they were here, they were both part of this, and they loved the Paul Whiteman music. And so that's our whole plan for this evening, is to have a great time playing this music, take you back to those great days of the Paul Whiteman Orchestra from the late 1920s, and bring Keith's vision of this music to life tonight. And I know he's here with us having a great time and enjoying a good sherry, and so we're going to kick it off with a tune that the band did not record, but we're going to give you our own version of it, Since My Best Gal Turned Me Down. Song. At this point, this is when Keith would have been on the microphone saying, ladies and gentlemen, and introducing the group. And the beauty of the internet is that we can bring Keith with us today and introduce the Paul Whiteman music. So I did a little research and found a clip. And so we're going to have Dave let Keith introduce our Paul Whiteman set.
Very nice, wasn't it? Lovely. Dance music at its best. Of course, the Whiteman Orchestra, of course, was the most famous jazz dance orchestra of its day, and the most highly paid as well, and one of the largest. There's at least 30 musicians playing in that, whereas most of the jazz bands in the early 20s were small bands. You'd be lucky if you got as many as 10 musicians. So we'll talk about Paul and his orchestra in greater detail a little bit later on. I have to talk about myself, because I've been fascinated with classic jazz and early jazz since I first heard a record of, believe it or not, Chris Barker's jazz band. I remember Chris Barker. I played the piano and accordion and learned classically, but I could always improvise. Something that my mother could never understand, improvisation. And I loved what was going to be jazz, you see. And when I was 14, I heard this record of Chris Barber, and I was absolutely gone after that. And my parents actually sold the accordion, which they were very upset about. And I took up trombones, so I played jazz, and I'm still a sucker for even now. So that's my story, and listening to these records, if you hear stuff from the very early 20s, it sounds very tinny and very far away, and it doesn't swing, it's a little bit stiff. And I was very, I'd read about all these famous people, and when I heard these early records, I thought, well, it sounds horrible, and my task, what I really wanted to do, was to recreate the sounds of those bands by rewriting all the music and getting modern, younger musicians to play it. And that's what I've been doing for the last 40 years, and I'm still standing. Absolutely amazing.
As living proof of Keith's dream that he had rewritten the Paul Whiteman music with young modern musicians, and we're all young on the stage. And that's a vision that Keith had, and that's what Mike Durham had for this festival too, and that's why it's so successful, and a big part to you, the audience, being here to support this music and be a part of it. So I wanted that to be our official kickoff of Paul Whiteman from Keith himself. So now Keith is here, and we're gonna now turn the mic over to Spatz on this next one for the vocal from November of 1927, a Matty Malnick arrangement entitled Mary, What Are You Waiting For?
Thank you.
We're going to keep the music going. Not too much talking between the sets because we have a lot of music to get through here, so we're going to keep things moving along. This is one that the Whiteman Orchestra did not record, again, another transcription that Keith did for the group, entitled Deep Harlem.
Thank you.
We are deep Harlem, so I'm going to introduce all the musicians at the end. You hear all these fantastic solos you've heard all weekend long, and so I'm going to do my best to pronounce, I think, all 23 musicians at the very end here. But the next song we're going to play actually comes from the Frank Trumbauer Library, and Keith scored this for the full Paul Whiteman style orchestra. So this is a great version of Clarinet Marmalade. Particular one you're probably used to, the Bix and Tram chase chorus, and that was Mike McQuaid and Andy Schumm reenacting that. And I wanted to mention, I apologize for anybody down this row. If you want to move, you're looking at my backside for an hour. That's not the most flattering view compared to that. So I have no objections if you want to move around. So feel free to do that. So I feel bad about blocking people's view here. So. So let's continue on. This is a Bill Challis arrangement from January of 1928. This is one of the, I think, first arrangements that Challis did for the Whiteman Orchestra, and was very essential in that band having that sound. And when Challis wrote, he wrote for the musician, not for the band. And so that's why a lot of the parts will have the musician's name in the upper left-hand corner. Instead of alto 1, alto 2, it actually have the musician's name, which I thought was really cool. So there's parts that say Bix and Tram, and so it's very, very cool. So this one is entitled Back in Your Own Backyard. One, two. beautiful Back in Your Own Backyard, January of 1928. Now the next one, we're going to bring Spats back up to the mic and sing this one. Again, this is February of 1928, just a month later the band made the recording. And a beautiful vocal that Spats is going to serenade you with here tonight and have you in the palm of his hand with all the sweetness. The next one. No, this one is entitled Sugar, Bill Challis arrangement. Spats will sing the next one, so I'm building you up for it. So, so this is from 1928, Sugar. Spats on vocals here. Another Bill Challis arrangement from April of 1928. Love this particular arrangement, and I think we have some group vocals on this. For no extra price, you get to have the extra vocal experience. So here we are with Louisiana.
This is the my backing group. And then there's the Spatcherettes. The Spatulas.
Thank you. Louisiana, Louisiana, I've been sad, boy I'm sad. Louisiana, Louisiana, now I'm glad, boy I'm glad. The train is going, the whistle's going, here I come, here I come. I'm tired of roaming, that's why I'm roaming back to happiness and then some. Louisiana, no place is finer, I declare, I do do declare. My friends are bluer, my friends are truer, anywhere, anywhere. Take me to your heart, maybe I must stop. As I live in the heart, Louisiana, Louisiana, my home.
Test for all the musicians. This will be the quickest song that we play, and if Matthias' fingers don't fall off by the end of this, he'll be good to go for the jam session afterwards. So he's got some flying fingers on this next one. This one is August 1927, so we're going out of the chronological order just a little bit. But this is a Don Redman arrangement, and you're going to hear it with Matthias and the whole band playing. It's hot, it's exciting, and we wanted to put it in this part of the programs while the guys still have that energy going with them. So this is entitled Sensation Stomp.
Thank you.
Alright, so the next one's from April of 1928. This one we're going to feature Spats on vocals for this. Legitimately will this time. This is a Town Satterfield arrangement, but this is also the time with Paul Whiteman that Ferde Grofé came in and started co-directing with the Paul Whiteman Orchestra. And that's a name and a composer and arranger that I've really been getting to personally lately has been Ferde Grofé, his Ampico piano roles, and just one of the unsung heroes of the Whiteman group. And it goes without saying, I mean, a lot of the musicians on stage are of that caliber for arrangers, because that's the music that you're hearing, is how they're arranging it, transcribing it, and it's that creative mindset of the musician. And that's what makes this festival so incredible, are all these musicians that are on the stage and the ones that aren't even performing tonight, is that you can't find this anywhere else in the world. And I mean, being in America and playing in the festivals, there's nothing like this. And so that's why this truly is a special place to be every year, and why it's an honor for me to be in front of all of these musicians, conducting them and just trying to hang with them, because they are all incredible musicians, but they are amazing people, sweet, kind, caring. And that is something that you don't find. Some musicians have those egos and you battle with them, but everybody gets along here, and it's like, as we said before, it's a big family. So that's how the Paul Whiteman Orchestra was, that's how all those groups were. So this festival is truly special. On that note, Spats is going to serenade you with "You Took Advantage of Me."
What's the use in trying not to fall? Got no will, you made your kill. You took advantage of me. Well, I'm just like an apple on a bough, and you're gonna shake me down somehow. What's the use? You cooked my goose. You took advantage of me. Well, I'm so happy bothered that I don't know. My elbows from my ears suffer something awful each time you go, and much worse when you're near. Now here I am with all my bridges burned, just wave in arms when you're concerned. Lock the doors and call me yours. You took advantage of me.
For you, but has it been sounding wonderful to everybody this evening? Yeah, really. This one's going to Whiteman and His Orchestra, 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 down in the front are Eddie Lang. We have Martin Wheatley. Special attention because Franz Sjostrom loved to play the bass saxophone with this particular unit, especially with Keith, because those two would be poking back and forth at one another there. And we have the wonderful David Hornyblow on bass saxophone. And save him for last. On our bass section here, we have Phil Rutherford on tuba. We're ready for it for the final time for this year. We have Malcolm Sked on tuba. However, there is an alias, an American alias that I was able to uncover from the Syncopated Times. And Malcolm said it was okay that I say this. So they were reviewing the Pershore Jazz Festival, and I was reading through it, and there was a name on there. I'm like, well, who is this bass player? And instead of Malcolm Sked, we had Michael Shedd on the string bass. So we had to do Shedd on the string bass. In our rhythm section, it's an honor for me to be here to perform at this festival, but to be with the other drummers that are here, because normally there's one of us at an event. But as I said, we're all like family, and it's a great time to be together, and we get to visit. And the first drummer I've known since I visited Spetsling and the Rhythm Boys in Davenport when I was a teenager. And his drumming was a huge inspiration to me, and it still is today. I love seeing him drum. We have Nick Ward on drums. Great friend of mine that I've known now for quite a few years, and really consider him and his whole family just like family. They're beautiful inside and out. We have Nicholas D. Ball. And the gentleman who helped organize all this music, Michael had this music from Keith's collection, but he was responsible for distributing all these parts to all these musicians. It wasn't me, I'm just waving the baton. That credit definitely goes to Claus Jacobi on saxophone. So this one is a Bill Challis arrangement that we're going to hear from May of 1929, Reaching for Someone.
Let's just have a quick thank you for our leader this evening, who he mentioned I first met him when you were a teenager, not me. He was excellent then and he's excellent now. Josh Duffee. Thank you.
Thank you.
traveling cat, very fond of penning, but I'm getting nowhere. Reaching for someone, not finding anyone there. Oh, la 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 la, no sweet romances to answer my prayers. Building castles that nobody will share. Reaching for someone, not finding anyone there. Is there a tune? Honeymoon. Is there a tune? Love is true. Is there a song in my heart? When I'm with somebody new, oh, who would worry, who would swell? Heaven is a Hades when you're up in the air, reaching for someone and not finding anyone there.
But again, before we go have a great time in the pub, I'd like to invite Jonathan and Patty up to say a few words here for the festival here. So can everybody please welcome Patty Durham and Jonathan Holmes.
We'd like to say a couple of thank yous, wouldn't we, Patty, I think.
Yes. Yeah, well, Jonathan, thank you very much. First of all, we thank all of you people for coming. We thank all of these wonderful musicians, all of you guys, We thank Klaus, where's Klaus? We couldn't do this without you. I couldn't do it without you guys.
Wow, come on.
We should say a quick word about...
I know you're from the previous
year. So, I couldn't do it without Michael. And I couldn't do it without myself either. No, obviously, it's a team effort, isn't it, really? We're all involved, and especially you in the audience for turning up, because we can't do it without an audience. Well, actually, we could do it without an audience. No, of course we can't. It's great to have you here, and we're playing it for you as well. So thank you for coming and making this possible.
Michael has worked very, very hard all through the year. Sorting out the rehearsal schedule and sorting out, make sure there's no clashes on any of the sets. That's a really hard task, and we do thank you for it, because these guys obviously need some rest in between sets, and it's a very hard task getting sure everyone is happy. So thank you very much, Michael, for that. And a big thank you to our sound guy as well for doing an excellent job in making these guys so awesome. And of course to all of you for coming. And when we look out in this room, I think obviously we see jazz fans, but we also see a room full of friends. And it's the friendships that are made at this festival that makes it really very special. And so whether you've come for the first time and made some new friends, or whether you've come again from previous years and re-established those friendships, really, really cherish them, because those friendships that we make here are special. On top of that music, it's like a really nice added bonus, I think. So, without further ado, I think we should hand back to Josh. And he's not working hard enough yet, so I'm sure we've got one more song in there. So, thank you very much for coming. We'll be back at the bar tonight for one more jam session. And we'll see you next year.
Well, on behalf of the Paul Whiteman Orchestra this evening, we all would like to say thank you for being here this year, and thank you for coming to our event this evening for this particular set. And how about a big round of applause for all the musicians who put all the hard work into all the sets. So on that note, we're going to do it to February 1930, Lenny Hayton arrangement. This one's going to get you going on the way to the pub there for a great jam session. Here is the Paul Whiteman version of Happy Feet.
Da 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 da